In this video, we're going to see how to graph marginal and average cost. We'll revisit the data from the previous video and plot the data. We'll then consider the relationship between average cost and marginal cost to proceed with a general diagram. As we saw earlier, marginal cost is quite high as production begins and then begins to drop due to specialization. As more labor is added to the production process, marginal costs start to rise. As for average total costs, we can see that they are initially falling, bottom out at about 6 to 7 units of labor, closer to 60 units of output, and then start to rise. You should also notice that at 7 units of labor, the marginal cost and average cost of labor are equal. Beyond this point, marginal cost is above the average cost and in turn causes average cost to increase. Let's visualize this data on a graph. This series of points represents the data we have on marginal cost. You'll see that while initially high, marginal cost drops to its lowest level at about 20 units of production. As output continues, marginal cost starts to rise. As for average cost, we can see that they continue to fall until about 60 units of output. Next, we'll bring the two together. The blue dots represent marginal cost, and the orange represent average cost. While marginal cost is lower than average cost continues to fall. At output 60, marginal cost and average cost are equal, and beyond this level of output, marginal cost is higher than the average. Let's look at it on a graph that you are more likely to see in your studies. The typical diagram you'll see of marginal cost and average cost is shown here. The marginal cost curve will always cut the average cost curve at its lowest point. This is because below this point, marginal costs are below the average and therefore bring it down. However, as marginal costs start to rise, the rate at which average cost falls starts to slow down and it approaches its lowest value. They're equal at the point at which they intersect. Beyond this, marginal cost is rising. So it pulls up the average cost of production, which explains the shape of the average cost curve. By now, you should be comfortable with graphing marginal and average cost. I also hope this video highlighted the nature of the relationship between average and marginal cost values. As you practice this more and more, you'll grow in confidence and understanding. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below or email me at enhancedtuition@gmail.com. That's us done for now, and I will see you in the next one.